At the recently concluded Consumer Electronics Show, Acer announced updates to my favorite budget laptop. Of course, I'm talking about Acer Aspire 5, a laptop that I have extensively reviewed on this channel. In this video, I will explain why I'm so looking forward to this hardware refresh. So without further ado guys, let's get started. Acer Aspire 5 has been consistently ranked at the top of Amazon's bestseller list in the traditional laptop category, at least for the couple of years that I have been, you know, following this laptop. So last year we saw the introduction of 6 and 8 core AMD Ryzen models in Acer Aspire 5. I've already reviewed these configurations here on this channel, and if you are interested, please check out those videos. It's linked in the video description below. Now these laptops offer a kick-ass performance, full HD IPS screen, good build quality, with backlit enabled keyboard, a decent trackpad, and ability to upgrade RAM and SSD, and they also come with large selection of ports. Now this year's update does not change the external design of Acer Aspire 5. Instead, Acer is upgrading the guts of this laptop by bringing AMD Ryzen 5000 series mobile CPUs. The model that has me most excited is the one powered by AMD Ryzen 5 5500U CPU. This model will retail for under $550. And it should be available for purchase in the second quarter of this year. Once I get my hands on this laptop, you can rest assured I'm going to do a detailed review of this laptop. So please make sure that you guys are subscribed to TechnoPanda if you don't want to miss out that video. Okay, now let's take a closer look at this new AMD Ryzen 5 5500U CPU. So here is a chart comparing this CPU with last year's Ryzen 5 4500U model. So the first big change is the introduction of hyper-threading. Ryzen 5 4500U did not support hyper-threading, so that meant you were relegated to only 6 cores and 6 threads. With this new Ryzen 5 5500U, you are getting 6 cores and 12 threads. So that means you are getting double the number of threads, and with these extra threads, this laptop should excel in multitasking when running performance intensive jobs like video editing and software development. The second and possibly the biggest improvement in Ryzen 5 5500U is the introduction of the Zen 3 core. These Zen 3 cores in Ryzen mobile CPUs are using a brand new microarchitecture that brings 3 key improvements over the older Zen 2 architecture. Firstly, it improves both the single-threaded and the multi-threaded performance. So here is a chart showing the Geekbench score of Ryzen 5 5500U. Compared to Ryzen 5 4500U, it is 5% faster in single-threaded workloads and a whopping 37% faster in multi-threaded workloads. So that's a significant jump in the multi-threaded performance of this chip. So I expect the new Acer Aspire 5 laptops to be, you know, total beast when it comes to multi-threaded workloads. The second improvement that Zen 3 architecture brings over Zen 2 is the significant improvement in the latency, both in terms of memory latency as well as the core-to-core latency. And moving on to the third and the final significant difference between Zen 3 architecture over Zen 2 architecture is the improved thermal efficiency. So this results in significantly longer battery life. Even though Ryzen 5 5500U is built on the same 7-nanometer process technology that Ryzen 5 4500U was using, AMD has somehow managed to improve the thermal efficiency, and this is largely because they have optimized the micro architecture. So with these three improvements, the new AMD Ryzen 5 5500U CPU should deliver superior performance and a longer battery life. Now let's take a closer look at the graphics. So Acer Aspire 5 powered by Ryzen 5 5500U is using an integrated GPU based on Radeon 7 graphics. This is an improvement over last year's model, which was using Radeon 6 graphics. This new integrated GPU comes with an extra execution unit and 448 shaders as opposed to 384 shaders found in Ryzen 5 4500U model. In iGPU FP32 benchmark, Ryzen 5 5500U delivered almost 40% improvement in graphics performance over Ryzen 5 4500U. So that means popular gaming titles like Fortnite will play smoothly at 1080p resolution without any issues. Of course, Acer Aspire 5 is not really a gaming laptop, so you will have to keep your expectations at bay. But for casual users, this laptop will provide more than enough horsepower to take care of all their multimedia and gaming needs. Like I mentioned before, Acer won't be making any significant changes in the existing design of Aspire 5 laptops. So just like last year's model, the top lid will be metallic, but the rest of the body will be made from polycarbonate or plastic. Now, I don't think this should be an issue for most folks at this price point. For example, my Acer Aspire 5 laptop, this is from the year 2019, it's still going strong, and I have had no issues with its build quality. So I've been using it for almost 2 years now, and the backlit enabled keyboard and the trackpad, they are going strong. The hinge has also held up really nicely. It remains sturdy and prevents the screen from shaking or wobbling when I type vigorously. I'm really a big fan of this laptop's hinge because it allows you to tilt the screen all the way back 180 degrees. This is really useful when watching videos or surfing the internet while chilling on your couch or bed. The 15.6 inch Full HD IPS screen is one of the best that I have seen in this price range. It pumps out around 250 nits of brightness, which is plenty good for indoor use, but I would like to see Acer bump the brightness by a few notches. 350 nits of brightness would make this laptop perfect for using in my backyard. So I hope Acer is listening, they are watching this video, and if you guys are watching this video, please make the screen a little more brighter. It will make this laptop a killer laptop for 2021. So overall, I'm really excited about the new AMD Ryzen 5 5500U model of Aspire 5. I've always recommended Acer Aspire 5 laptops to all my friends and family members who are looking for a sub $550 laptop with kick-ass performance, great keyboard and trackpad, large Full HD IPS display, and plenty of port choices. By the way, I have linked all the existing flavors of this laptop in the video description below if you want to check them out. So please let me know what you guys think of Acer Aspire 5 laptops in the comment section below. If you found this video useful, please like and subscribe to TechnoPanda. Also check out technopandareviews.com for more reviews focusing on gaming laptops, laptops, and desktop PCs. So again guys, thanks for watching this video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye! In this video, I am reviewing an affordable, thin and light Ultrabook from ASUS. In this video, I will give my first impression of Lenovo IdeaPad 3 powered by Ryzen 5 3500U processor. In this video, I am going to pit two of my favorite 2-in-1 convertible touchscreen laptops against each other. In this video, I will list my favorite convertible 2-in-1 Windows laptop that you can buy this holiday shopping season. In this video, I will share my experience of using Acer Swift 3 laptop for the last 6 months. In this video, I will be reviewing the 15.6 inch HP Envy X360 2-in-1 convertible laptop. In this video, I will be reviewing an Android tablet from Samsung that directly competes with the iPad. In this video, I will be reviewing a mid-tier gaming laptop from ASUS. Can you guess the price of this laptop? It has a gorgeous 15.6 inch Full HD IPS display, a huge trackpad, and a full-size keyboard. In this video, I will review my top picks for a budget Windows laptop that you can get from Amazon as of now. In this video, I am reviewing an affordable, thin and light Ultrabook from ASUS. In this video, I will give my first impression of Lenovo IdeaPad 3 powered by Ryzen 5 3500U processor. In this video, I am going to pit two of my favorite 2-in-1 convertible touchscreen laptops against each other. In this video, I will list my favorite convertible 2-in-1 Windows laptop that you can buy this holiday shopping season. In this video, I will share my experience of using Acer Swift 3 laptop for the last 6 months. In this video, I will be reviewing the 15.6 inch HP Envy X360 2-in-1 convertible laptop. In this video, I will be reviewing an Android tablet from Samsung that directly competes with the iPad. In this video, I will be reviewing a mid-tier gaming laptop from ASUS. Can you guess the price of this laptop? It has a gorgeous 15.6 inch Full HD IPS display, a huge trackpad, and a full-size keyboard. In this video, I will review my top picks for a budget Windows laptop that you can get from Amazon as of now.